you're an auto enthusiast, I mean, this is like the mecca. You think about the heritage and the history as you're lapping around the track, it's just nirvana.
You can explain to people what it's like, but until they come and do it, they can't really get an understanding, because you can go back there and be all excited and blah, blah, blah. And they still, when they come here, they just go, you told us it was great, but we didn't realize it was going to be this great, you know? And that's just what's really special about the place.
The car is taking shape very well. It's running good lap times, and we're ready to go out and go even faster.
There's no other facility in the world like this. You can accomplish more in one lap around the ring than you can running probably a dozen tracks in the U.S. There's places you go airborne around the track. There's full compression loading, you know, as you come through a valley. You have off camber and on camber and, you know, compression loading in the cornering through the carousel. You can't experience all those things in any one facility anywhere in the world except here.
Coming up to Hotzenbach, where this is a real rhythm section. Right, left, right, left, right. Hit your marks, use the curbing if you need to. Our MR shocks will gobble it right up. Coming up to Flugplatz. Car gets airborne. Immediately you tap the brakes for a 100 mile an hour right-hander. Really demanding on all attributes of the chassis. Obviously the Nürburgring ring wants to use all of your brakes and all your ends and all your tires. This is the section that really chews up the tires. Here we come up to the carousel, wide open throttle. Then stand on the brakes, let the car slide and jump right into the carousel. And it shoots you straight back out. Like being shot out of a gun, you're pulling approximately 1.5 G's because of the banking. Now we come up to Hoach, the highest portion of the track. Try to carry a lot of speed through this next section. Just light taps of the brake, trying to stay in third gear and maximize the cornering speed. Time for another carousel. The car drops in pretty abruptly, really trying to focus on the steering feel. Onto the back straightaway. We primarily use the straightaway for chassis tuning. The car is precise and not meandering. Another hard braking section, the tight ending of the track here, and that's it.
2809?
2814.
Yeah, that's all right. Well, it's been a long 2 weeks. We've put in a lot of long days. We've made great progress with our steering, our brakes, our suspension. We've put down a great lap time, and we're about ready to wrap things up.
Being here is just a tremendous experience and a privilege, just a tremendous honor.
Looking for a new car or truck? TheAutoChannel.com has the most complete and up-to-date pricing, vehicle specifications, and reviews.